Welcome back to Tran Fails at the Forest. It's been a real life day. And while I was editing and rendering episode one, we went ahead and set up a tarp in the recliner cave and just farmed the heck out of these storage crates. So while I was editing and rendering, there's a lot of time that takes place during that. I set up on my laptop my character and just kept loading the save file with the storage crates and open them up. And then I would save and then load the storage crate file again. Basically, just every time I load the game. The game is really annoying about letting you drink sometimes. Like, here is water. I'm waist deep in the water. Let me drink. I know I drank from this river before, or lake, or whatever. Now I'm swimming. I saw it a second ago. There we go. I think I also managed to drink while my character was falling in. Yeah. Kevin, get up. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and start heading back to base. Now that we've spent some time away from it, we can probably resume construction on the base, since I'm assuming the natives will give us some peace and quiet back at HQ. One of the reasons, if this is the first video you're seeing of mine, the reason why I'm slicing up the branches all the time is to try to build up my strength. My strength is currently at level 10. It's only day 9 right now. So I'm working my way to the next cave. Bit of lag there as I strike the tree. I don't think I'm necessarily... Yeah. Apparently I left Kevin... What? This is why I'm taking him back to base. I'll leave him alone for now, but geez, I hope if he doesn't meet me by the time I explore this next cave, I'm probably gonna restart the recording. Hi, Kevin. All right, well, you did make it to me. Every time I'm near water, my sound really breaks. Alright, it looks like we're here at the cave. What I like to do is if Kevin happens to be following me, I tend to try to make him do some work while I'm exploring. Well, I spent 6 sticks on that. Kevin, you need to find at least 6 sticks. And I wish that this would automatically default to fill holder instead of drop here. If you're not near a holder, it doesn't even appear, so there's nothing foul or harmful about doing that. I know my character's tired, but it is daytime, and I don't want to waste daylight. It's hard to record at night. Like, this is what it would look like. I do wish your character would immediately withdraw their flashlight. I do wish your character would immediately withdraw his flashlight when he enters a cave. If you're carrying a map on you, he'll withdraw his map first, even though it has absolutely no use in the cave. I know that happens to be what the user was using when he enters the cave, but there's no point in wasting the player's time like that. We're gonna go and eat this cat food. I see I have a fish available, but we could get the fish to rot after a day or two. But we will definitely lose the canned food if we don't pick it up now. Pretty much all the caves I've been in look like this. It's just a very small treasure room of basic items. You can see I'm maxed on rope. Looks like my character at some point gained a level in strength. You get 5 sticks. That is, I wonder if 5 is like your carrying limit. Alright, well, I'm maxed on sticks. Hi, you're just gonna throw them all. Get sticks and follow me. I'd rather you get the log, but I mean, we'd have to wait for you to chop down a tree. Dude! Oh, you can only carry 2 sticks, what? Fine, whatever. I can't carry those over 6 because I'm max capacity already. Alright, so let's head back to base. The game has patched, and I can actually now open up my quick inventory. I'll need to reconfigure it, but I can now do that. I was not anywhere close to what I was aiming at. Well, he's at least moving. I don't see him yet, though. He probably moves better when you're not watching. I just hope that he can find some way to follow me then. Pistol rail. I don't know what it does. Will it tell me? No, it doesn't tell me. Does it make it more like less recoil? Does it make it less recoil or something? I don't know what a rail is. Silencer. Okay. This dude is packing. We're gonna make a temporary shelter here in case I ever need to find this place or maybe show it on the map. Since it shows houses, we're gonna just build a hunting shelter here. Normally there's more than two logs. Oh, there's another one. Look, I'm just gonna tell you that if there was a man throwing logs at me, I probably wouldn't try to punch him. Every hit he does apparently costs me two of my leaf armor. I know leaves aren't very particularly strong, but that cost me a cloth too. Yes, run away where I can't watch you or protect you. In fact, you're running right towards where the guy was. As always, Kevin, the sooner we get done with this assignment, the faster we can return. Let me think here. I want that body so I can get the bones. I saw his arm just at the last second. Gain legs a lot when something for the first time happens. Such as placing a rock, or pulling out a rock. There's no shelter icon here, so maybe there has to be a certain number of buildings before it counts. Whatever the reason, this will be easier to find in the future, anyways. Alright, since we happen to have rope here. Whoops. What else do I need? Not gonna put that on right now. Because health regenerates, and I can max out on medicine. But armor I have to constantly replace. Okay, I don't want to hold the rope. Maybe it'd be smarter to hold the axe, game. Yes, because I want to hold the stick instead of the axe. Kevin. Alright, well, let's see here. Since I can now do my quick inventory. Alright, let's... Okay, game's lagging. I didn't even click anything, I just hovered over the book for a second. That's what the patch note said, is if you remove the book from your backpack, your quick inventory slot would break. I'm removing it now, let's see if it still breaks. Up the torch. Alright, that looks pretty good so far. Maybe medicine and energy. Alright, that looks pretty good. And I still want to equip the axe, so we'll do this. Been a while since I did that. I told you to get a log. Then at least follow me, dude. Follow. You won't at least carry something, at least stay with me. How can he 360 hit me like that? Thanks, game, for make me hit the tree. Okay. So much lag. I feel like the lag got worse after the patch. Lag tells me to hit the tree. Oh no. Stop your death throw animation. I don't care. I want you to turn into bones. Skin pouch. I'll take all the bones I can carry now. Whoa, no, that's not what... Game, that's seriously how you're gonna treat me? If I max, you're just gonna make me throw the bones on the floor, which get despawned when you load the game. Alright, fine. I gotta figure out how many bones I'm allowed to carry then. Get out of the water. Alright. I am allowed... 15 bones. Right, I killed everybody that was following us. Are you capable of following me? Man, Kevin's running alongside the river right into that pack of ferals. He's seriously running into them. I apologize for the giant sound bug. It's just super windy in the game right now. All the sound is really off. And the other people I've watched, they also feel that the sound is a bit off. This one's not marked. Oh, quiet. Finally. Either that or the game's crashing. One of the two. Okay, see, this is what I mean. I did not hit the M button. I've been hitting the F button for him to pull out the flashlight or lighter, but he insists on opening up the map again. Okay, well, this seems like is an exit of some sort. That's probably why the cave is not marked. As soon as I get to the base camp, or at least the printer save, I'm going to save and re-log in, help myself to some resin while we're at it for the trouble, but that gets rid of the wind sound effect. That was quite the lag. It's really distracting, the wind. And yeah, normally motion blur is off, but when I entered this area, for some reason, it's still completely active, or whatever you want to call it. Alright, we'll make a save here, and we'll see if the wind is no longer windy. Welcome back. It took me half an hour to get back into the game. This room, actually, I should probably print something. How about we print the sled? Then I'll talk. The game took... I waited about 20 minutes trying to wait to the... main menu of the game, get back to the main menu of the game, and eventually just had to close the application. The thing is, I only was recording for 37 minutes. That's counting all the lag stuff that I may edit out. And previously, before the patch, I was able to play for maybe 2 to 4 hours. It is 4:10 in the game. They broke something. I had another skull thing over on this side. They must have smashed it. Okay, I would like you get sticks and fill holder. Now, since this doesn't give me any stamina loss, I'm assuming that I'm not getting strength for this. But I'll try to keep an eye on the pixel perfect of the strength meter. I'm losing stamina because my character is swinging in the air, and I'm not perfectly aligned with the next one.
Yeah.
I get frustrated if, like, I get killed because the game refuses to let me cut the carving I want, or the defensive wall I want. Like, what good is cut? Maybe this one's defective. I don't know. Pointing at something, but I want. All right, dude. That's enough. Just follow me. Move with a purpose, dude. That'll keep them. We'll see. Alright. Stay at shelter, huh? Stay hidden. A second ramp somewhere. Okay, so game does not actually pause when you're in this menu, but I don't know, maybe the enemy's less aggressive or something when you're in it. So that does give you reason to have your quick slots available. That's fine, we'll go ahead and leave those things on there because that's what I'm going to be using for the next few minutes. Okay. What's with the magic sound? Alright, what was I doing before I just got distracted with that? I needed cloth. It's over here. Okay. Probably lost the cloth doing it. Not sure I understand. Put the cloth on, then put the skull on, and then light it on fire. Oh, does it? Oh, it creates its own light. Okay, I didn't know that. Okay. Can I reinforce it so it doesn't get broken by random attacks? I guess so. Apparently that was too long. I can't tell in the dark whether it's cooked or not, but apparently I just burned up all the fish. Okay, he's getting more fish, I guess. Wish you could hit one and pull out a weapon. Yeah, I need that fish. Give! Okay, our character is completely ready to roll. Let's take a nap. Wow, dude. Alright. I would like you to stay hidden. Don't need that right now. Spears. Oh, actually, let's put the bow on there. Medicine, energy bar. I think we're good. How are they getting over? I assume they couldn't get over the spikes because it was peaceful at night. Either that dude's tall or he's standing on something. Okay, I don't think you know what hidden means, dude. Apparently he's just tall. Yeah, I saw you earlier. Should be able to do a finishing strike when they're like that. There's a fish somewhere. I don't see it anymore. Did I pick it up?
Yeah.
I'm over here. I'm not at the base. Come follow me. Wow, he is fast. Trying to hold for power swing, but my character, yeah. All right, well. Carry more circuit boards, huh? Stun baton. Go ahead and grab that circuit board. Alright, well, the last one of these was a serious cave. One of the wooden areas.
Wooden barricaded caves.
So, we're gonna set up a base inside real quick. Lots of meat laying around. I'm not really sure that's the kind of meat that we want to consume. Wow, okay. That's interesting. He likes to think about setting up that tarp. I know I only need one stick, but I just feel like it looks way better with two. All right, let me think here. What else can we do? I know. In real life, you would probably asphyxiate. All right, need some more sticks and some more. Okay, let me harvest some of those things. We're gonna go spelunking. Perhaps this is just overkill, but who knows? I tend to always overprepare. I was trying to grab the axe, but All right, that's my cue. Pistol, flare, torch. It's a very odd place for the torch, but okay. Did you just remove my axe? I want the axe. I would like the bow, too. So I can only have, like, three primaries? Is that what's going on? Fine. Bow, axe. Come on. It's ridiculous. I can pick between the axe and the torch. Ah, fine. Let me take care. Okay, if I want to do that, switch. Okay. Just wanted to make sure I had everything set up. Flashlights. Let's go ahead and equip that. So loads. Okay. And we'll go ahead and re-equip the pistol since apparently that does not take up the range slot. And we'll make a save. If the game lets me. As I sleep on top of that hand. See how much light this makes in a cave. I probably don't need to kill them, but I'm gonna try, because I just saved, so... Not sure what I ended up using my rope on. You can kind of see that one down there, walking. I don't think I can hit him. Let's see what happens when I miss. Is he alerted? Does he immediately know where I am? I wish there was a reticle. I don't know. Is it right in front of the arrow tip, maybe? Don't come to me. I didn't know. How is... I feel like I'm just wasting resources at this point. I know that there's water down there. Oh, nice. It's hitting each other. Fine. You know what? Alright, that just seems pointless. I'm gonna load. But yeah, I set up that base camp so I could defeat the enemy, but it might not really be a good idea. Sneaking through them like I did the first time might just be the best route. I mean, I spent 20 arrows, 2 Molotovs, and a grenade, and what did I get for that? I killed maybe 4 unarmed enemies, and there were still at least 2 running around. Maybe I'm just bloodthirsty, I don't know, but I don't want my efforts at setting up a camp go to waste. Maybe it's still good to have made a save. And I can always still use those sticks to make regular fires throughout the cave so that it's not pitch black, which is one of the reasons why I brought in the stick holder. Okay, game was broken. It was, it didn't quite register that I was in this menu. Okay, so let's switch out this axe for the bigger axe. That looks fine for right now. Is there something else I wanted to do? I'm not sure. Now this raw meat I'm carrying, just so you know, this is from the squirrel and the rabbit outside. When I was back in my base. Whoops, I don't need to pre-cook the fish. I know there's literally raw meat right here, but I am not touching that. I'm not eating that at all. Oh, I can set up another stick. That's why it's asking me. Alright. I was thinking about heading out and to loot those canisters again, but it's not really that big a deal. If I fail at this next move, I try loading again. I don't have to make it perfect, but I would like to find some sort of optimal means of fighting. since I have 50 sticks, seriously? Is it like counting all my inventory or something? Can you do that without getting cooked? Okay. I know there's no silencer on it. That's on purpose. I want to try to see if I can torch them. They might not actually be smart enough to climb up to me. I thought they would be. Oh, that one might. That one might. What if I was up here? How about right here? Come on. Almost there, just a little I don't know if it's because they're smart enough not to walk in the fire, but I doubt it. But maybe it is affecting their pathing, for all I know. Is my aim better if I put away the flashlight? No. Alright, let's try this again. Oh, hey, what's up? I can't tell where my character is aiming without a reticle. I really can't. Maybe that just means I'm lame, but I mean, I put his head in the center of the screen and I end up shooting him in the chest. I understand that, you know, your eyes can move independently of your hands. I get that. But as far as the game is concerned, I don't know where my hands are pointing. All right, well, let's try that again. Stealth and arson didn't work. I guess it's on to something else. Well, it looks like they noticed. I guess I'm invincible while that's happening. The heavy axe is, looks like it's too slow to retaliate immediately after parrying or blocking. Takes a while for the harvest action to appear. I'm not sure if pushing the body helps make it go faster. It's the second time they've missed me by when I was crouching. Maybe that's a technique you can use against them. FYI, this is what we are looking for, it says. All right, here's what we're going to do. Even though this will mean that the enemies respawn if I load the save, which may end up happening, probably will end up happening, I'm going to go ahead and save here. We can get some time bombs, more shotgun ammo, if that all respawns. I'm at full health. It's not like I've actually... save here. And while we're at it, we'll see what this guy's capable of. Lag. Okay, here we go. Well, this is a special circuit board. No, I'm just saying that it didn't respond fast enough, but I had selected it. Chunky! Boxes sound weird when they're getting moved. Did he detect me? Oh yeah, he... They've done more damage to each other than they have to me, or me to them. It's always a three-hit combo, but the fourth one is actually overhead. So if I block the first three, I could crouch below that third one and then swing while he's doing his fourth hit. What? Could at least just automatically put it on or something? I don't see it. It's probably just gone forever. Lord, my workers are having a lot of trouble getting anywhere inside these caves in complete darkness. We need more lighting in there. It's a safety hazard. Light it up like a Christmas tree. Hank. I find eating the pills like that way more disturbing than anything I'm doing here. I've been spotted. It won't stop any concentrated effort. In fact, running into it fast enough will just knock him over. But who knows? It might do something. It might stop him. It might distract him. It might make him lose scent of me. I don't know. It's just a couple sticks. I've always thought it was ridiculous that games seem to care more about your sound than anybody else's. Bats, water, other monsters, they all make lots of sound. I also try to avoid shining the flashlight directly at the enemy in case it does alarm them somehow. Say this is a shine one right at this guy. Over the rock. I wonder how good these guys' senses are. Pretty good, apparently. I guess I'm loading a new area. still lagging. Maybe it means it's spawning a bunch of enemies. So I guess it does mean I'm in a new area. missing CEO. There's a single arrow in this. Let me pick up any of the bones. It's ridiculous considering... Oh, I can pick that up. It's ridiculous considering they're trying to show me all this gore. But as a player, all I see are bones and think, oh, crafting ingredients. Let me pick that up. I'm not thinking, oh, gee, that's horrible. I'm disgusted. And I was like, oh, I should mash E. All right, let me think here. Start with this and start throwing and then maybe follow up with arrows. Okay, I got one. Yeah, that's not gonna help. It won't let me, obviously it won't let me pull the string while the flashlight's out. I really wish there was some sort of marker. I can barely see where my arrows are going. Oh, that's not how you switch arrows. This. Stock of my arrows, see if I got them all back. 24, 20. I'm missing one microfiber, and I'm not going to head back to that chest for one, because there's plenty in the printer room. But if I find it, that'd be nice. Alright. I'm glad that the arrows kind of glow in the dark. I don't know if that's intentional, but it's nice. Otherwise, I would have no idea what I'm aiming at. All right, let's count how many arrows on this body. Ten arrows. Maybe if I carve them up, it'll let me take my other arrow back. Oh no, I didn't mesh armor thing. Oh, okay. I had enough creepy armor. Oh, that's because I didn't get to collect it from the previous dude. I got driven off. Does it even hurt if they hit me? I've got 3 armor right now, we'll see. It's just them. Well, I didn't have a chance to find out. They probably aren't there just to alarm the enemy. And maybe creep out some people, but... Zombie babies or mutant babies or whatever these things are do not bother me. That bothers me. Those things take a lot of punishment. I see a baby running towards me. Oh, did it call for that guy or something? Pausing a lot. I am coal. Use sticks to build a fire. Alright, equip. And... equip. Does this work? I think it's ridiculous that the torch has to be wielded in the primary hand, but it did work against the cold. Okay, did take off 1 point of armor. Perhaps the best strategy is wait for them to get stunned, then beat the baby senseless with your torch. Demonetized! There's another one somewhere. Alright, so they do damage. I just didn't take any health damage because I used up my armor. Rope gun. Nice. Does it mean I'm taking a cloth or I'm gonna use that? No, okay. I want the cloth. There was another path. Leads back. It'd be a entrance past the babies if you wanted, if you could find it. It's really unfortunate I can't make armor off of them. that didn't work. I hit E so that I could get the cloth, but all it did was make my character drop off. Would have gone right here. Okay. Now, I feel like I could just run, but because it's dark up ahead, and the game hasn't generally thrown enemies at you when in pitch blackness. Alright, well, I mean, come on, game. Don't crash on me now. I feel like the graphics suddenly changed. I was loading the next map, I see. Something's in front of me, but I can't tell what it is. Oh, just rock. That right there, where the flashlight's pointing at. Well, I'm having a lot of lag issues, so let me make a save as soon as it lets me. Here, let me just go back inside and save. Because it's nighttime, I might as well do rest too while I'm at it. Is it? It is 4:48. So if I rest now, that's gonna be such a waste of a day. It's fine. No, we won't rest. Oh, I wanted to save though. Well, while we're at it. So we're about to go back into wild. Yummy! What else is there? That's it. I think that's everything. I'm gonna make a, well, switch my axe. I don't need that as my hotbar item. It would work as a hotbar item, though. I don't see anything that I'd really use that the game would let me. It seems it only lets me have two weapons, and maybe two guns or something. Seems fine to me. Make our save. Finally, at last. So that was a really long cave. I was a little overprepared for it, but it was somewhat challenging. I hear something. It sounds like one of the babies, frankly. probably need to restart the application. I just want to mark this cave in case I ever want to know the exit. Come on, game. Those are my shelters that are marked on the map. I am cold and wet. I'm not cold anymore, but I'm probably wet. I wanted to head to back to base to send Kevin there, but there are still some caves I wanted to explore. And I may return to that cave just to remove the shelters, because they seem to be cluttering up that cave, but I'll remember that as a monster laden cave. If the monsters don't respawn, I'll go in there and finish them all off. If they do respawn, then it's a place I can get creepy armor. So, there's a reason to head back, one way or another. I'm not sure which one of these caves to go to first. Probably this one next to the exclamation mark. And I'm assuming the exclamation mark's the GPS thing that I've already picked up twice, so I will turn right instead of go left. And yes, the sound is funny to me too, in case someone's jumping in for the first time. Because that's just the way the game audio seems to be working on my computer. Also, this doesn't seem to be setting fire to the wilderness. That was just my torch. I'll continue to do my strength building exercises. Thought I heard music or something. The cannibals are still walking around at this time. Considering they're completely naked. I don't know what that earlier sound was. It sounded like some sort of, oh, yeah, it's that guy. Slingshot. Cool. Money. And another super cane. I'll see what's wrong with this. This looks good. I know I just saved, but we're gonna, since this is one of those barricade caves, we'll do that again. Okay. Just so you know, that was not planned. Normally I do plan out a route like this, saying like, okay, we'll do this cave first and this cave. I just happened to be heading... That was always my intention to return to... a base, drop off Kevin, and search these mountains, because I didn't want to babysit him going up and down the mountains. like there's stairs back. Okay. Oh, I didn't even realize I was in water. I'm doing it in the middle of winter. Awesome. Can I use the spear when I'm in water? Nope. Well, I've got plenty of oxygen. I have my initial tanks. I'm always good at looting. I feel comfortable. I just wanted to check around. I figured I'd have to go in this chasm, but I figured I'd look around first. I wonder if this automatically uses my rebreathers. If it does, that means it's actually better than Dead Space in this category. At least I'm assuming in Dead Space you would not use your air. I've never ran out of air in Dead Space. Hello. I would like to crouch before walking anywhere. But I'd also actually like to harvest this person before doing anything else. Let me harvest this person. Of course. I think it went through the floor. Alright, well, there's two of them. I'm gonna try to get them both to drown. Then I will use two armors. Like ice or something? It won't let me go up. The water is my domain. Assume that's all of them. So I will put on three armor since there's four bodies and I failed at looting one of them. You had the loot earlier, the loot icon earlier when I was down here. Oh, see, there it was again. Just push you to the surface. This is ridiculous. Just let me harvest them. It's a game where you make these as resources and you don't let the player collect the resources. I see the E key. I'm trying to push you uphill too. There we go. Oh, had it for a second. Oh wait, my dude's doing it. Alright, that's one. 2. Three. That's all of them. I mean, if I can find the one I threw away, that'd be nice, but I doubt it. Pretty sure they just vanished forever. Wanna join your friends? Yeah, come on in. This is, the water's awesome. Are you seriously gonna drown? I can understand that one, but you? I thought it was this one, but I thought I saw the E key on that one. The lower one right now. This is ridiculous. Just let me take... There we go. That's how it should be. Just making sure I got everybody covered. Okay, my dude wasn't pulling out the flashlight, probably because I was harvesting in the water, so it was confused. There's a lot of bad guys. It was like, what, 6? Okay, I know the rebreather's over here. I think the air tanks are also next to it. Oh, that's lame. What if I unequip it? Then use. There we go. You have to unequip it first. There's no indicator that you've unequipped it. Wetsuit collected. Ow. Oh, I think I'm gonna lose his armor anyways. Yeah. Okay, I guess I'm sliding now. That's a thing. I don't even see where my guy emerged from. Was it that? I unequipped my oxygen thing. I don't know why you put it back on just for that little dive. But alright. I'll leave it on while I'm in this cave anyways. But I unequipped it so that I could refill the air. I don't think I was full on ramen. It's my last drink. I've got energy drinks. Wow, are you trying to tell me something here, game? So I harvested this one and this one. There's three more, so we'll don three more pieces of creepy armor. Hopefully this does not hurt my diplomatic relationships with the natives on the outdoors. I mean, they should be a lot more understanding considering what they do to me. I think I hear another one. Oh, that's not very fair. I just turned the corner. I don't know your attack pattern. Ugh. dude was completely tuckered out on stamina. All right, here's what we're gonna do. Energy drink. All right, and you know, it's time for the cat food. And before we harvest, does this body actually block me? I think it does. Yeah, I'm standing on it and everything. I saw another one earlier. I see two of those spitting mutants. Flashlight attachment. Oh, that sounds nice. Ah, there's the mysterious spider mutant. Okay, I don't think he actually knows I'm here. Let's get a little more light. I can see okay, but my main worry is trying to make sure that their footage is good. Not what I was trying to do. Run, dude. I was holding shift. I've noticed that after you get up from crouching, your dude takes a while to start moving. No, I ran out of habit. I'm not used to a game just throwing away my gear like that. Alright, well. Okay, it doesn't seem that they're alerted because that one's still spitting everywhere. I see the other one walking away, so we'll go and set that fire again. It's like the game knows when I'm trying to do something. We'll use flashlight. Oh, actually, it took him off. He had to hoist the flashlight all the way up before I could go back to inventory. Since I had the lighter out, I should have opened the torch first. Not open, used the torch first. Game's lagging quite a bit. Apparently my torch is still lit from earlier. Okay, then we'll switch to axe. Oh wait, I can't switch to axe because I'm using the torch. Durr. I see the spider one, and there's a baby one right there. Hard to move. I didn't get to search that red crate, but it's probably the same stuff as in other red crates. Well, I guess if I was hungry, there's some legs. I don't know why there'd be severed legs down here. Like we've done this before, but okay. Yeah, I don't know why there's suddenly a larva would be emerging from the water. Apparently they immediately hear it. Water that I can't even see. It'd be nice if I could get them all to drown like before. Especially those larger ones on the back. There we go. Trying to alarm them all. I'm tempted to just chuck a grenade at this point, but I actually have to open up my inventory, and I can't even do that. I can just fly on this water. When it does that, that's it letting you know it found you. I still can't open my inventory. And so yes, what I'm doing is cheesing for sure. But otherwise, I'm walking straight into a group of about 7 to 8 enemies that are alerted with me. I didn't even touch the ground yet and they were alerted at me. We got one left. You can also just slash it to death, but I've got to keep an eye on that one. I'm trying to get to the ground so I can switch to a weapon. Apparently that one just charged all the way from over there. Come on in. I gotta try to bait them into attacking, I guess. There we go. You're a goner now. I get my axe out again. Sure no one's gonna sneak up behind me. Alright, there's 3, 4, 5 enemies. So that's 5 armor I need to put on. 4, 5. Like a rhino. I am holding E, by the way. Okay, go straight down, game. It's not letting me. Try this again. I'm holding E. I mean, just in case it happens to let me harvest anybody. I am buoyant. It keeps pulling me up, no matter what I'm doing. I want that armor. That's 5 armor. I can't even see what I'm doing. That's the ridiculous part. I'm setting another fire. If I take off the rebreather. It just keeps putting it on automatically. And I do apologize, I know it's not the most riveting gameplay, but this is a game in early access, and one of the surest ways to make sure that a problem gets solved is to make sure it gets known. No, I'm not making excuses. Normally this is the kind of stuff I would edit out, or even just not do. I'd say like, oh, okay, I'll just get armor off camera, which I do a lot. If you've seen any of my playthroughs, you'll see that. It's like, oh, I'm just gonna go get this off camera. Come on, I want these. So close! Haven't harvested one of these yet. I need to add it to my collection. Alright, one more pass and I give up. All right, I'm out of here. Anybody else need to take a bath in the hot springs back here? I see movement. saw a spider, but I managed to sidestep it, I think. Now it's ahead of me. I don't know if it's that one or a different one. And I think there's probably a regular mutant, regular monster just on all fours running into a wall. Oh, come on, game. Okay, sure, I'm sure that's a majestic sight, but right now I'm kind of fighting or trying to avoid getting slaughtered. Okay, shovel. Okay, invisible wall. I'm gonna babies and the spider monster will hit the invisible wall. Swing down, dude. What's one of the problems with canned animations? He's aiming everywhere but the thing I'm looking at. Rotten fish. Fine. I'm pretty sure this is nothing that you should be doing. Downing an energy drink, scarfing down cat food, and then taking a whole bottle of whatever that is. All right, so I'm at 8 now. Yeah, it's like literally, I can't go forward. I'm trying to go forward. Okay. Now the question is, how do I go back? I assume I would use the shovel to go back. I am cold and wet. There's not much I can do about that right now. Money. Okay, that explains the money. My max on grenades? Is that what that means? Well, let's go ahead and refill our air canister. Yeah, I thought this was the area I'd been through earlier. I'm still not sure I know how to get back, though. Oh. Okay. I guess that's how. That also explains why it gave me so much C4 bricks. Nine grenades. I'm not sure if that's max, but I know I'm at max Molotovs. Okay, that's a pathetic explosion. But at least I get a bunch of them. I don't know. Maybe that's realistic. But that definitely is a little disappointing. Well, they're stunned from the Molotov. Quickly, get them. Man. Tapping right click as you do this, which I guess is some sort of parry or riposte. I guess I can't swap to flashlight torch combo. I feel it's a good sign for some reason there was a skull there. It makes it feel like the exit's up ahead for some reason. Okay, well, I mean, doesn't necessarily mean that I'm right about that. I don't understand these things. I mean, I could outrun them very easily. Only issue is I don't want them alarming other mutants. find that this, having to switch within lighter and all this stuff constantly is just pedantic. Maybe that's how survival games are meant to be played, and it's fine. I just don't like it personally. Alright, well, another thing to deal with. Cat food. Energy drink. And we're gonna set down my last tarp, apparently. Have to go farm some or something. I just like having a fire. Even if I run out of sticks and I regret it later, I just like fire. Okay, still have the flashlight. And of course the torch. Safe. This so far has been a really good and productive journey. Let's get going. I hear a spider thing. I think more than one spider thing. Okay, well, Kevin is approaching me, and this might be a cave that I checked out earlier with where there was just a dead end. Where are you at, Kevin? I hate how you just sort of... Fine. Follow me, dude. Level 12. I don't even have to hit anything, apparently. I mean, I kind of figured I didn't, because I have swung in the air before, but it isn't as entertaining, I think. Plus, I've always declared war on things that block vision. For example, if you saw me play Dismantle, I think I destroyed every bush and every tree that got in my way. I'm gonna need the torch out so that my character doesn't freeze. I don't have any warmer clothing. We'll see how it looks during the daytime after a while. He almost got me. I dodged to the left just in time. See, there's always some sort of audio sound, which I'm glad. Otherwise, I'd probably always be on edge about wandering, especially at night or something. Oh, shoot! Okay, that hurt. Why won't my dude run? Oh, he's in crouch mode, apparently. Broke his legs. Actually, I kind of want to make that my base. I guess when the ice melts, it won't still exist. Am I even heading the right way anymore? Yeah, that did way more damage than any random attack would. My favorite description of Dying Light is falling to your death simulator. Yeah, if I had known it was just going to leave me outside, I probably wouldn't have prepared so hard for the next leg of the journey. I thought I was just two-thirds of the dungeon. Turned out to be the whole thing. That's why I wasn't worried about finding more arrows, because there's always here. It's almost daylight, and maybe we can start building at the base. How many pistol bullets do I have left? 25. That's still a lot. I don't think I was reckless with it, but I did spend quite a bit. In fact, I'm not even sure I shot the pistol until then. Oh, I found a new thing while I was down there. That's right. We want to put that up. Cool. I think that's ice, which means my base is not defensible anymore. Right, I need to figure out a new place. Let's make a save here and then I'll think about it. I'm just looking at the map right now. I mean, okay, we're going up the mountain then. You and me. Everything's already snowy. We'll figure it out. Wasn't really planning on taking them with me, but now I am. The place is just not defensible anymore. Not that I think he would get attacked when he's by himself and I'm across the world, but who knows. Plus, I wasn't really that impressed when it turns out that those... How did you end up over in front of me? Did I misunderstand something? Am I going the wrong way? I don't think I'm going the wrong way. Well, I am getting near that cave. I can grab my tarp back. Over here. Oh, nope. We gotta go. Apparently this is like his permanent spot or something. There's another one up ahead. I will say that there are many reasons I don't like winter in this game. Everything looks the same now. I'm glad I have a decent sense of direction, but everything looks the same now. You couldn't even tell I was standing on what would have been a road. I have to have the torch out basically all the time as well. This could be solved if, for example, I had other clothing, but you can't make it, which means that I can only find it and I assume that it's not randomly generated. You have to find exactly where that item is. And I have done a lot of running around. I actually haven't spent that much time building. Yeah, Kevin's not coming with me. Also, having a little bit of trouble swimming upstream, I guess. Kevin, it's cool. You could have met me this way. Can I get him to turn back around? Yeah. All right, well, I'll see you on the other side, dude. Use your hands. Run parallel with them for now. They need to go in this direction. I'm still badly hurt from that fall. I am curious where this road leads. In the GPS, it looks like it just ends in the water. Okay. All right. Well, we've been to that cave. And we were in that cave. That was probably the one we just went to. Well, what I need to do is go to that cave. And when I'm saying that, I'm basically trying to point directly up of my GPS. Guess I could hit this cave bottom here. I could probably do with a resupply. I assume I have no ability to kill that thing, because I've tried ambushing one before. I just want the hide. Maybe if he'll part with the hide, we can leave in peace. I had the axe selected, but apparently it's the crafted spear. I think. Okay, it picked the rock. Cool. It's still picking the rock. I need the axe. I actually kind of wondered if it could hurt me. The answer is yes. And also it can survive 2 power attacks to the face. But I still see it in the distance. This is the one that I hit earlier. Like how it's just an empty black hole. Alright, this should just be a treasure room. And give me a chance to restock. Probably have replenished my stock of canned food. Kevin, where you at, dude? He's literally under the ice. And he's swimming after me. I can only hope he teleports. I may try making a save to see if he warps. So if I do, and you see me load the other save where I'm back at the other camp, the earlier camp before we left on this expedition. Was there a pickup? Oh, I thought it was an arrow. That's what was going on. So I will make a save right now on top of this hill and see if he appears anywhere near me. If he doesn't, we'll just load the other save of the expedition. We'll see if he appears. If not, I'll rewind time.